Jack Daniels, one of the most well-known brands in the world. Well, hello Malt Montanas, Ralphie here, welcome to Whisky Review 158, and I'm going to not be reviewing old number 7, I'm going to be reviewing Gentleman Jack, and I'm going to explain why. This whiskey is young. It's well young. It smells of tasting notes, sort of glue, boiled fruit, dried fruit, glue, Airfix glue for plastic models. It is a very young Tennessee whiskey indeed. Called Old Number 7, and there's various, you know, legends about it, but I suspect it was sample number 7 of probably a range of about a dozen samples, and it happened to fit the profile of what Jack was looking to create, known to Jasper, known as Jasper to his friends. The poor chappy famously died after stubbing his toe on a safe and getting blood poisoning. Oh dear. And as he had no immediate family, other relatives took over his distillery, and being Tennessee types, they didn't want to be kind of considered along, you know, with Kentucky bourbon and other bourbon counties. They wanted to be distinctive and different, and so they called their bourbon whiskey. And what they did was introduce a special feature to production to create a little bit of individuality, and that feature is the fact that the new make spirit is passed through a vat of charcoal, where two processes go on. One is the purification of the raw young spirit to a certain degree, and secondly, and importantly, they're not using any old wood for their charcoal. They're using sugar maple wood, which has a very high sucrose or sugar content, and therefore this ain't just charcoal. They're using its sugary, caramelized charcoal, and that adds a certain sweetness to this spirit. So there you have it. This is the whiskey that you have with ice or Coca-Cola when you're RSI, IRS, well, your big tax revenue bill comes in, or your healthcare premium for the rest of the year. It's also the one that you drink when you're out on your shovel head, your flat head, whatever your kind of head your Harley V-twin has, and you're going interstate. This is what you have on the rocks. I am going to be tasting this one because it's a step up from this, and it's way better quality. Simple as that. Worth noting, as I put this out the way, that Jack Daniels produce quite a range of their spirits. They're a bit of a collector's item amongst the Jack Daniels fans, and well, they're doing anniversary editions, limited editions, editions left, right and centre. Let's pour some and see. Again, as I mentioned in my last review, watch these flat-sided bottles. They can be a little bit weak. You know, I'm actually, you wouldn't believe the amount of moisture. This is a traditional Manx bothy, and it's not a typical of a bothy. It's rather a damp environment. I've got the fire on at the moment, and it's still damp. In fact, there's condensation in the side of this bottle. Anyway, nose. Distinctly different. There's darker notes, there's more caramel, treacly notes compared to the Jim Beam that I last reviewed in the 9-year-old Knob Creek. Incidentally, named after the 16th President of America, Abraham Lincoln, who was born and raised in Knob Creek Farm. There you go. Moving on. Gentleman Jack, it's a step up in price, but it's quite widely available, and in my opinion, it is light years ahead in quality. The single barrel is probably one of the best of the Jack Daniel's range. Again, it's quite pricey. Standards do vary, but as a single barrel bourbon, I am assured by John Lamond and other experts that that is indeed the case. Ooh, I'll add a wee drop of water to this. Now, let me see, what's the strength in this? 40%. It doesn't give an age statement. What it does say in this little label is introduced by Jack Daniel Distillery in 1988, blah blah blah, iron free water, blah blah, cave spring, blah blah, more back going, honored, time honoured, yeah, process going back more than 140 years, this rare Tennessee whiskey. Rare, by the way, is the most overused word for world spirits. You go on eBay and look at all the whiskies and bourbons and all the rest of it for sale, how often the word rare is mentioned. I'm going to add a wee drop of water, but not much, because it's already down at 40%. Half a teaspoon, that'll do. Nose. Spicy floral. Interesting nose, engaging. Slightly bubble gum. Sweet frappleberry. If you're in America, you'll know about frappleberries. Makes quite a nice ice cream. Vimto. And pink fruit. Right. Vimto, incidentally, is... This is Vimto. It's a fizzy red fruit mixed drink with some herbs in it. So look out for that if you want to get a kind of that tasting note. Intense, right? Mm-hmm. Slight Airfix glue still in there. Just getting on the taste because it's on the nose. And there is a slight sharp quality to this. This really benefits from a drop of water and being left to sit for 10 minutes with a cap on it. Even after that, this is still a very much a volume produced spirit, and it reflects in the finesse. It's still decent, don't get me wrong, it's fine, but be aware of that. Tasting. Once it's been given a 5 minutes with some water in it, the red fruit comes out, the Vimto comes out. Delicious arrival, yep, of red fruit and Vimto with allspice, red currants and jelly babies. Jelly babies, check it on the internet. Very popular British sweetie jelly babies. Even Doctor Who enjoys jelly babies. I bet you watch that programme. Raisin and angelica, right? With water, the spicy note lengthens and it makes for a better whiskey. The finish, again like Jim Beam's Knob Creek, isn't huge by any standards. It's reasonable, but it's nothing compared to Elijah Craig or the other smaller producers. But, marks, 84 out of 100, and that is a Tennessee whiskey bourbon mark. There we go. Ooh, ooh, ooh. See you soon.